In this video, we'll discuss about construction and working of venturi meter, which is used to measure flow rate of fluid in a pipe. The venturi meter works on the principle of Bernoulli's equation, which state that the total energy of fluid flowing through pipe is constant. This means that the sum of kinetic energy, potential energy, and pressure energy of a fluid remains constant. That means increase in velocity of fluid results in decrease in pressure. The venturi meter consists of three main parts: the converging section, throat section, and diverging section. The converging section is the inlet section of venturi meter, where the fluid enters the device. It has gradually decreasing diameter. The throat section is the narrowest section of venturi meter. It is a cylindrical section with a constant diameter that connects the converging and diverging sections. The pressure of fluid at this point is lowest and its velocity is highest. The diverging section is the outlet section of venturi meter, where the fluid exits the device. It has gradually increasing diameter. The venturi meter should be installed in a straight section of pipe where fluid flow is fully developed. When the fluid is used to pass through venturi meter, there is no pressure difference in inlet of venturi meter, but at the throat, the velocity is used to increase and there is decrease in pressure. This is due to decreasing cross-section area from inlet to throat. This pressure difference between inlet and throat is determined with the help of U-tube manometer. This pressure difference is used to calculate the flow rate of fluid in the pipe. The flow rate of fluid can be measured by using this equation. Now we will see how to derive this equation. So let's consider a horizontal pipe in that the venturi meter is fitted and the water is flowing, as you can see in the diagram. The P1, V1, D1 and A1 are the corresponding pressure, velocity, diameter and area in section 1. And the P2, V2, D2 and A2 are the corresponding pressure, velocity, diameter and area in section 2. Now applying Bernoulli's equation in both the section 1 and 2. Here the H1 and H2 will be eliminated because both having same height from the ground. I will rearrange the equation in order to get the term at the left hand side, that is P1 minus P2 upon rho g, which is pressure rate difference, and it is denoted by small h. Next, we are applying the continuity equation, which is the product of cross-sectional area and velocity. So we will get V1 equal to A2 V2 upon A1. Now I will put the value of V1 in above equation of small h, and after simplifying this equation, we will get V2 equal to A1 into under root 2gh upon under root A1 square minus A2 square. The discharge through venturi meter, that is capital Q, equal to A2 V2. Where for V2, have already obtained the equation, so I will substitute this value. So this is the discharge through venturi meter under ideal condition, which is called as theoretical discharge. And the actual discharge is the product of theoretical discharge and coefficient of discharge. The value of coefficient of discharge, that is CD, is varied from 0.95 to 0.99. So here we have finally made the derivation of venturi meter.